people from tier one institutes leaving their jobs with the high packages are coming towards this path because they see that it provides them a sense of purpose. Exceptional dedication, intelligence, and perseverance. Varda Khan has not only excelled academically, but has inspired many with her commitment and determination. Introducing Varda Khan, who has cleared UPSC 2023 with All India Rank 18. Varda, welcome to India Times.
Thank you.
How are you feeling? It's been a month since your result has been out. Has it sunk in yet?
Of course, it was too overwhelming, especially for aspirants who've been quite isolated in the journey. I think I've been able to process the result. I was glued to the phone, but as luck would have it, the moment I left my phone and when I came back, it was flooded with messages from my friends. Everyone just mentioned Air 18, Air 18.
Varda is a beautiful name. Iska matlab kya hai?
This name is very special to me because it was given to me by my father. And Varda means red rose in Arabic.
बहुत लोग college के बाद ही preparation start करते हैं. And I believe, as per our research, you were already working with a renowned MNC like KPMG. Then what made you think of UPSC?
Naturally, I grabbed the job the first opportunity that came my way. But like at the end of the day, when my working hours got over, when I analyzed that what I actually contributed towards the society and whether I was able to impact any person's life by just analyzing the figures, checking legal compliances throughout the day.
Mm.
So there was no sense of satisfaction, and the syllabus and the pattern of this exam was so multidisciplinary that it naturally piqued my interest.
Dealing with the loss of a parent is incredibly tough. How did it affect your decisions?
If I were to draw a contrast between both my parents, so my mother was someone who you always used to keep me grounded, that even if I had gotten good marks, she wouldn't make a fuss about it. But my father used to celebrate every small achievement of mine. Naturally, when I decided to appear for this exam, and throughout the journey, I used to remind myself that I am doing this for him, because had he been there, it would have been the greatest joy of his life.
You're originally from Allahabad.
Yes.
So was switching cities difficult? Because I remember my father was in the army. And when I moved from Bhopal to New Delhi, it was like, you know, during school and college, it can definitely take a toll on you. Just like leaving friends in school behind. How was that for you?
You're very true about the transition part being difficult. Allahabad is, or Prayagraj as we call it now, is a relatively peaceful place. And whereas in NCR, we know the life and everyone is in rush generally.
Correct.
But gradually, I got acclimatized with the environment.
Very recently, economist Sanjeev Sanyal said that UPSC is extremely boring and that there is poverty of aspiration. What is your take on his comment?
I think it wouldn't be wrong to call this aspiration as a middle class aspiration in our country, because we see this as a very lucrative avenue of upward social mobility. And to have that respectable job and a respectable position in regard for ourselves and our family in the society. I would say that one takeaway that we can have from this statement is that one should be clear in their mind about the number of attempts and the number of years of the youth they would devote towards this exam. Because I'm also of the opinion that it is not wise for us to exhaust all the attempts, because it certainly becomes difficult when we go back to the job market and people have to struggle a lot. But bureaucracy again is a necessity for a developing country like ours, and it's certainly good that there is a reason why people from tier one institutes leaving their jobs with the high packages are coming towards this path, because they see that it provides them a sense of purpose to impact the society, to transform people's lives.
What was your plan B?
I had decided my plan B when I had to sit for second attempt only. Like when I failed my first attempt, I realized that I cannot put all my eggs in one basket. I need to, you know, hedge myself against the risk. So when my mains got over in September, I sat for CAT, which is for MBA. I was able to score a decent percentile, as a result of which I converted a few B schools, relatively like tier 2 B schools, I would say.
How did you balance your study schedule during your UPSC preparation?
I won't say that I'm a very early riser, neither I'm a night owl.
Oh.
So I used to wake up around 8 and my day started around 9. and it started with reading of a newspaper. And I used to keep two subjects at a time so that the studying doesn't get monotonous for me. So one subject I used to do in the morning shift and another in the evening shift.
Did you stop traveling, socializing, chilling?
I used to attend a couple of get-togethers, like the Diwali parties that they used to host at their flats. And I used to attend my friends' birthdays, but these would be very occasional outing.
In our research, we also found out that you've been storing pens that you had used during your UPSC preparation. What does it remind you of?
When I would get the opportunity of writing my first mains, then I'll also collect these pens as a souvenir, and they would remind me of the hard work that I put. Let's see that if the ink has been able to write the revolution or not.
Ah, lovely. One question maybe probably you were asked at the panel that you think would have changed your fate.
One of the questions was, since you've worked in one of the big four, so why is it interestingly said that the consultants tell the companies something that companies already know? I replied that maybe because not earlier, but right now, almost everything is outsourced by the companies to the consultants, right from, say, the ideation, the strategizing to the execution part. This is done to wean off the responsibility also for important decisions, especially by the upper management of the company. And at the end of the answer, he just smiled and said, ki ye to bahut badi baat keh di aapne.
So tell us, Varda, is coaching a must for success?
I think this is a very subjective question because it depends on a lot of factors. Your UG background, whether you've been acquainted with the subject and the syllabus, and also people have a lot of affordability issues. It is totally the aspirant's call to take the coaching or not. Having said that, there are a lot of free resources on YouTube and a lot of mentors also who provide free videos and material from which people can learn.
Do English medium candidates have an advantage?
I certainly think that they do have an advantage there are a lot of reasons for the same. First of all, resources are largely available in English medium, especially for optional subjects. Like if I would say about my optional sociology, paper one has a lot of foreign thinkers, and we have a dearth of material for Hindi medium students. Mm. And secondly, most of the teachers and the good educators on online platforms, they also teach in English medium.
Is there bias against like caste, religion or region? Did you face any?
I don't think so. The institution of UPSC is very transparent and very balanced in this sense, because I'm not sure if a lot of people know, like in board exams, our name and anything that is an identifier for us is hidden from the evaluator. The similar thing goes for the mains examination also. There are guidelines given to all the panelists that you do not have to ask any politically sensitive question or any question that might hurt the sentiments of the candidate concerned, or anything related to their identity as such.
Where do you see yourself 10 years down the line now that you've cleared? What's your focus?
I'm not sure if I have a very long-term vision in mind considering the foreign services, but I do hope that I get the opportunity to represent my country on UN and other international platforms.
Any message for UPSC aspirants, or you know, especially girls?
More than the girls, I would like to give a message to their parents.
Yeah.
I've been fortunate to have been supported by my mother in this journey. This is a message to the parents, especially of the girls, that we are already working under the pressure of clearing the exam, the uncertainty around it. So please do not put the added pressure that you have to clear it in these many years. Or for a lot of girls, there's a pressure of getting married also. First of all, your child has taken a very courageous decision. So I would say, despite having cleared the exam, I would say it is a big gamble in one's career. A lot of people leave their jobs, lucrative opportunities to pursue this. So they are already playing with fire, and you can at least be their solace in this grueling journey, and do not impose any kind of added pressure and expectations on them.
Is Varda Khan dating? Is she seeing someone, anyone special in her life?
No, ma'am. I don't think that the preparation phase gives you enough time for that.
So now maybe now there could be some hope.
I don't know.
Thank you so much, Varda. It's been an absolute honor speaking with you on India Time.
Thank you.